गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो इन द एट स्टैंडर्ड वी हैव स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 2 माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. सो इन दिस वी हैव स्टडीड व्हाट आर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, types of microorganisms. Let me write the main points of it. First of all, what are microorganisms? I will write the introduction. Then after, types. Then after, useful microorganisms. Then we have seen the nitrogen cycle. Then we have seen harmful microorganisms. And then we have seen we have seen harmful microorganisms. And now in this video we will see the microorganisms and food spoilage. We will see microorganism and food spoilage. So in this we have first of all seen introduction. In that video, Harsha ma'am had told about what are microorganisms and what are the types of microorganisms. And then in the next video, we have seen the useful microorganisms which are used in our daily life. And then we have seen the nitrogen cycle, the atmospheric nitrogen travels to living organism and also in the soil and comes back to the atmospheric nitrogen and harmful microorganisms, the organisms which harms to our body or animals, plants are known as harmful microorganisms. And now we will see microorganisms and food spoilage. Okay. So, microorganisms and food spoilage. So there are some microorganisms which spoils the food. Means if we see an example in our home, in the summer season the mother used to made pickle, achar banati hai na mummy ghar pe, to usme bhi ek वो स्पॉइल ना हो जाए उसके लिए विनेगर और सम ऑफ दी लिक्विड रिएजेंट आर एडेड इन इट सो दी पिकल डोंट स्पॉइल. ओके, इन दिस इन द बुक देयर इज वन एग्जांपल. लेट्स सी दैट. See, here in the yellow box, there is written an example. Maya has forgotten a sandwich inside her tiffin box, kept in her school bag through the weekend. There is a one girl who have forgot his tiffin box in his bag from weekend. So, in the tiffin box, there is a sandwich. Means there is the sandwich has spoiled now. I think so. Let's see that. Will the sandwich remain the same or would its color change? Will it smell? Will she find something growing on the bread? If yes, describe the growth. Would the sandwich develop this growth if it was kept in the fridge? Will this growth be more in summer or winter? Why? So, there is answer. The sandwich will smell. Matlab usme se gandi badbu aayegi. And there will be a grayish white growth on it. Matlab growth hoga. So, for the first answer, will the sandwich remain the same or it would color change? Will it smell? Yes. उसमें यह आएगा कि उसका कलर चेंज क्या होता है, ग्रेइश वाइट ग्रोथ ऑन इट, बराबर है. एंड इट विल स्मेल. विल शी फाइंड समथिंग ग्रोइंग ऑन द ब्रेड? यस इफ डिस्क्राइब. मतलब इसमें क्या ग्रेइश वाइट ग्रोथ हुआ है. इसमें द ग्रोथ इज द एक्चुअली फंगस कॉल्ड ब्रेड मॉन्ड एंड इट विल स्पॉइल द ब्रेड. मतलब वो फंगस, देयर इज वन टाइप ऑफ फंगस व्हिच स्पॉइल द सैंडविच और ब्रेड. Microorganisms cause spoilage of various foodstuff by growing on them. A somewhat warm temperature, air and moisture are needed for microorganisms to grow, which then release substances that contaminates the food, making it unfit for consumption. Eating those infected foodstuff can cause food poisonings. In this example, we have seen Maya forgot his sandwich for the weekend and the sandwich has spoiled. It can't be eaten. If we eat that sandwich, then there will be food poisoning. So, if there is food poisoning, then our health will have a disease. In our body there will be disease. Okay, then next, there are some points. See, let's see. We should not consume food if it has a foul smell. Matlab usme se badbu aati hai to wo food hame consume nahi karna hai. Food that has microbes growing on it will have a slimy feel or may have developed a visible cotton like growth on its surface. If there is a microorganism growth in any substance, then there will be cotton like substance on it. So we will know that there is microorganisms in that substance. Next, infected food may look discolored on its surface. There will be color change if there is microorganisms are developed or growth on the food, then there will be some color change on the surface of the food. Next, the food would taste sour or many have a strong gas like smell that gets formed into microbial growth. Means there will be bad smell and we can't even smell that. And the food is in the vessel and it is covered, and if we open after some days, as we open the vessel, there will be bad smell coming, and then we will know that the food has spoiled. Okay, let's write some points. Sorry, next. Food preservation. The next point is food preservation. So, due to this food spoilage, we have to do something so that the food is preserved for the long time. So, preservation, food preservation. Food preservation. Food preservation. So, what is food preservation? If I talk, I give a definition by my own, then we will say from which the growth of microorganisms is stopped on the food and the food doesn't spoil. Then we have to add food preservative. We all have one example that vinegar is used as food prevention. Vinegar is used for food prevention. So, there are some points in it. So, first point is boiling. In this, we see food is preserved by boiling. If there is a water part in the food, then we have to boil and all the microorganisms which are there in the food, it will its death happen. Okay students, next point. The another one is dehydration. So, first of all, if we take a simple definition of dehydration, so the removal of the water is known as dehydration. So, what is dehydration? The removal of water from any substances or from the food and all things in which there is water and we have to remove. So, this is known as dehydration. Then, what will be if we talk dehydration? Then, what will be hydration? The water molecule is added, then it is known as hydration. So, if there is a water molecule in the food and due to that there is a growth of microorganisms in it. So, if we remove the water molecule from the food, then there will be no growth of microorganisms. So, there is a process known as dehydration. The water molecule is removed from that, so the growth of microorganisms is not there. So, this method is used. Let's see the another one. So, the another method is canning. So, what is canning? Some food items are heated at specific temperature and then for a particular time span, and then it is preserved in the airtight container is known as canning. Heated at specific temperature. Heated at specific temperature for some time span and then it is preserved in airtight container. Is known as canning. So, if we talk canning, the food is heated at some specific temperature. If there is different food, there will be some different temperature and different time for preventioning it. So, heated at specific temperature for the some time span and then it is preserved in airtight container is known as canning. मतलब क्या? इसको जो food है उसको high temperature पे heat करेंगे for some time and then it is added in the airtight container is known as canning. Let's see the another one. So, if we heated and kept in the airtight container, there will be no growth of microorganisms, so the food will not spoil. Okay, students? Then the next one is refrigeration and freezing. If we see refrigeration and freezing, freezing. We all know that after freezing, we take an example. So, we all know when if anyone in the home takes some fruits or vegetables from the market, then after washing it, we used to kept in the fridge so that the microorganisms are not growth on the surface of that. So, canning, we take an example, then fruits and vegetables. So, if anyone from the home buys fruits or vegetables and then after washing it, it is kept in the fridge, so the growth of microorganisms doesn't exist. If we don't put this in the fridge, fruits and vegetables, if we don't put in the fridge, then there will be the growth of microorganisms in it. So, we have to put it in the freezer for preserving long time. Next, we will see adding chemicals. We all know that adding chemicals means we use to add some chemicals in the food so it prevents from the spoiling. Thank you. adding chemicals. We all know, we have studied in the previous standard that vinegar is used for the prevention of the food. So if we add vinegar in any of the food the food is not spoiled. So there in the pickle, vinegar is used for preserving long time, and we will see the different example of it afterwards. And next one after this is pasteurization. So if we heat the food or any substance at very high temperature and then it is cooled, then all the microbes in that gets death. So there is no growth of microorganisms in that. So if we take an example of milk, all the milk bags which we buy from the any shop or milk shop, then that package milk is first of all heated at very high temperature and then it is cooled, so all the microorganisms in that will die and there will be no spoilage of milk. So it is used in milk. Okay, now we will see textual. What is written in the textual and examples of it. So there are many ways by which we can prevent food spoilage. Let us look at the method by which we can preserve food and prevent them from spoiling. The process of treating and handling food to prevent spoilage and save its nutrition value, texture and flavor is called food preservation. Matlab जो उसकी क्षमता है फूड की एंड विटामिन्स एंड ऑल विच इज सेव्ड न्यूट्रिशंस विच इज सेव्ड इज नोन एज फूड प्रिवेंशन. माइक्रोब्स स्पॉइल फूड एंड सो इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू प्रिवेंट देयर ग्रोथ. वी कैन डू सो बाय आइदर किलिंग द माइक्रोब्स और प्रिवेंटिंग देम फ्रॉम द ग्रोइंग एंड मल्टीप्लाइंग. देर आर मेनी मेथड्स बाय विच food can be preserved and different methods are used for preserving different types of foods. Boiling. First we have seen boiling. Existing microbes in food can be killed if we boil the food at high temperature. So matlab jo if we boil at high temperature, the microorganisms in which the food is there, it will get its growth will control. And we all see the example of milk. When the milk comes to our home, then first of all we heated it, then next second is dehydration. If we remove water from the food items, they can be stored for a long time as water is not available. Microbes do not multiply. The process of removing water and drying up a foodstuff is called dehydration. I have said in the dehydration, I have explained this. Pulses are generally dried under the sun to preserve them by removing the moisture present in them. Nuts, chips and some fruits such as grapes are dried and preserved by the process of dehydration. If we take an example, in the monsoon season, all in the home talks ke bhej lagi jase, then the mom is used to take it to the sun, and so the water molecule which is present in it is dehydrated, so it is preserved for the long time. Canning. Some food items are heated at specific temperature for a particular time span and then preserved in airtight containers. This is called canning. Fruits, vegetables, fish, even cooked foods are preserved for a long time by this process. This is known as canning. Refrigerator and freezing. If we keep the temperature low in the refrigerator, microbes can not multiply, means the growth of microorganism doesn't exist. Hence, freezing and refrigerating helps to preserve food. Items like fresh food and vegetables, meats and certain vegetables are also frozen to keep them for long time. Adding chemicals. Certain chemicals can be added to food to preserve their nutrition value for a long time. Such chemicals are called preservatives. Preservatives are added to preserve squash, sherbets and ketchup. Certain substances like salt, sugar, oil and vinegar are added to food items to prevent the growth of microbes. Okay, next one is pasteurization. When we heat the food item at very high temperature, then it is cooled, rapidly cooled. Microbes get killed. This process is known as pasteurization and it is very effective to preserve foods like milk. Most of packaged milk that we get from the market is pasteurized food. So students, we have studied today the microbes and food spoil and the food preservation. If there is a spoilage of food, then we can also preserve the food by adding some chemicals, boiling, dehydration, pasteurization and other examples we have seen. So I hope you have understood, and now we have finished this chapter, microorganisms. If there is any doubt, we can discuss in our group, or you can also message me. And so now this chapter is complete, and write today's homework. So the homework for today is you have to write some definitions. Okay students, first, microorganisms . Second, nitrogen cycle. Third, food preservation. Fourth, pasteurization. Fifth, communicable diseases. Okay, so you have to write the definitions of all these five: microorganisms, nitrogen cycle, food preservation, pasteurization, communicable diseases. So up to then, stay safe, stay home. Bye.